Hello everyone, welcome back. This is Ibrahim Qureshi here and this is my session 7 on VMware tutorial for beginners. And today we are going to see I'm going to introduce you to the HTML5 client. So obviously we have already been working on web clients, so I'm going to the topic I have suggested the name as introducing web client and HTML5 client is purely because I want to show you both the clients again and show what we can do with them. So let's get to the demos. Okay, so when you log into the vCenter, you get two options: launch vSphere client HTML5 and launch vSphere web client. So let's launch web client first. This is what we have been using. I haven't introduced you to the HTML5 client yet, but today we are going to see that in action too. Let me launch it in the background. So okay, this is the vSphere web client. As you can see, most of you might have seen this. I have been using this from day one. There are different tabs here, just to go through from the introduction for this. VMware is now advertising the launch vSphere client HTML5. Which is the new client going forward. They want to make this client web client absolute, and they will basically focus on this one. The problem is the HTML5 client is not there yet. Maybe it's 90% there. People say it's 95, but I doubt it. There's a lot of stuff which you can't do with the HTML5 client yet. So let's quickly go through some sections here on web client, and then you can understand the same sections how we can go through on the HTML5 client. Okay, so I'm clicking on the ESX host and you can see the CPU, memory and the storage. You'll get basic information here, which you will obviously in the other client as well. Over here on the top you'll see home, and then you can see home, host and clusters, which is where we are at the moment here. And then you'll say VMN template, which is the second tab here. Storage here, as you can see, storage is here, and then network, and then you'll find other stuff here as well. So if you click on home, really what it will do is it will take you to the home screen. So this is the home screen here. So it has hybrid cloud manager, it has obviously the licensing here, the roles, and obviously if you're giving permissions, you need to be you need to create a role before you can assign permissions to anyone. Host profiles, that will be handy as well to roll out servers. Update manager, again this is one of those things which is not available in HTML5. Customization, VM storage profiles, event console, task console. So there are quite a lot of stuff here. The primary stuff which we will be using is all these. So cluster and host and cluster, VMware template, storage and networks. So let's quickly go in VMware templates. So over here you can arrange your data in a really nice format. So if I expand, oops, too many clicks. So you can see I have created folders over here, and if you right click and create new folder, you will be asked whether you want to create a folder for cluster folder or network, storage or VMware template. So you can see it very easily. So it has to be a customized folder for VMware template if you are creating it for this one here. In this I have organized some stuff. So I have my UCS manage, Cisco emulator working here, and you can see the new VMs which get created, they get in this section. In the VMware I have vCenter, and then I have. So you guys can get a rough idea how we can use this folder. So we could have a folder for Linux, folder for, you know, appliances, folder for Windows, and SUSE Linux, and obviously separate them in containers like these folders here. Then the next step is the storage. So obviously in my environment I only have local storage and I have SSD storage to my host, but if you have a shared infrastructure and you have a big storage when big storage unit, then you can present it to VMware and you can have storage, and then you can collect the storage within clusters, similarly how we do for VM for the host really, and they can do clever things like storage VRS, DRS, and you know, balancing for the storage. And let's check the last tab, the networking tab. Obviously on my environment I don't have any virtual network, a lot of virtual networking done, but we can create multiple port groups for different VLANs and for different workload, and you can have different VLANs for, you know, management, vMotion, and you know, FT traffic if you want to. Oh, here obviously this is my home lab, so there isn't anything like that, but you can create these things, and we'll go through how to do that in upcoming sessions. So let's quickly jump on to the thick HTML5 client. So as you can see, this client is also having similar you know, tabs here on the top. If I click on one of the tab, again shows me everything which we saw there. In the menu you can see now update manager is here. So up until now this was not available, and you also have auto deploy, VROps operations is here as well. Wow. So anything you basically deploy, if you deploy like a login site for VMware login site, that will basically have a module here installed. So you can click on home. So the home over here, if you click on home, is a little bit different. It's like a dashboard, VROps dashboard pretty much, which I like about it, because you can have a quick glance of how much CPU is your environment using, how much memory, how much storage you have got remaining, how much is used, VMs as you can see, and the vCenter. Yeah, this is what I was telling about the installed plugins. I couldn't remember the name at that point. So and like we can have a login site plugin, or you know, VRO plugin. So these plugins are installed and we can see it here. So update manager is already having a plugin here. So as you can see over here, alerts are two. If you click on that, PSC's health check. Okay, I'll post create archive service health check. So that should be okay now, because we had a clean reboot 192. Okay, so we cleared all the alerts, and then when we go back home, it's not driving me back, so that means it's cleared. I think it may take time to clear this alert from here. So you're getting a general idea of what this web client is about. So we have policies and profiles, which is usually used for vSAN stuff as well, and obviously for NSX if you are doing that. Now you can see administration here, and administration was also available in this tab, in this web client. In here, as I was talking about, we can create custom roles for someone we want to, you know, assigned. Over here it looks a little bit like this, which is good to see. If you have more than one vCenter in the same SSO, then you will be able to see that here as well. So from the drop down, you'll find another vCenter, and then you can choose that. So that's really it. Really, I wanted to keep it short and simple. Probably from the next time we can start using this. There's a lot of things to learn, I would say. Set up the home lab at home, and obviously start playing with the product. Only when you play with the product, you'll get used to it. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below, and then I'll be happy to answer them. Let's quickly go through the final slide which I have. So again, don't forget to subscribe and like my videos, comment down below, share it with your friends, and leave a comment below as well with the question of the day which I'm going to ask you. Which interface do you prefer, the web Flex client or the HTML5 client? So you have seen both of them now. Just leave a comment below and let me know which client do you prefer. Okay then, thanks, bye.